After a poor start for equity markets this month, UK markets are bouncing back today, Tuesday the 4th of June. Let's look at today's small cap movers. Oil stocks are in the spotlight today. Let's start with the shares in Enegi Oil. They are up after the company revealed farming potential. An unnamed consultant working to enhance production from a well on its Garden Hill field in Newfoundland has said it wants to farm into the field and the firm's EL1116 license. The news, revealed alongside a production update, provides potent third-party validation of the two assets. Enegi said it has yet to decide whether it will accept the offer. Sefton Resources says it's making good progress with its operations in Kansas. The AIM-quoted oil firm reported that oil production was up to 450 barrels a month in May from 400 barrels in April. And it also revealed that a deal is nearing completion for the company to take full ownership of the Dark Horse operations in Leavenworth County. Through the deal, Sefton's interest rises from 42 to 100%. Fastnet oil and gas shares were also in good shape today after the company revealed its proposed farm out of a stake in the Foum Asaka exploration license in Morocco had received expressions of interest from several multinational oil majors and national oil companies. However, the process is still at the early stages, the company has said. In the mining sector now, Herencia Resources shares were gaining ground after the company said it expects to have a number of options to fund the development of its Paguenta mine. However, Herencia also said the funds will not be needed until late next year. Earlier this week, Herencia unveiled a feasibility study for the silver, zinc and lead project in Chile that showed a pre-tax net present value of $78 million and a rate of return of 20.4% over 8 years of underground and open pit mining. Herencia told investors there were a range of options to finance the project, including a silver stream financing, offtake agreements, a mezzanine finance, conventional debt or equity. In other news now, Nyota Minerals said a review of development at its Tulu Kapi gold project in western Ethiopia indicates the asset is tolerant of a lower gold price. The company said it has been working over the last 3 months on optimizing the returns offered by the project. Now let's move on to Union Jack Oil. The company has said it is looking to add to its growing portfolio of onshore UK hydrocarbon assets. It has negotiated an option to acquire a 5% stake in production and exploration license 068 from Montrose Industries for £175,000. The area contains the Westerdale gas discovery in North Yorkshire, which is estimated to contain 8.6 billion cubic feet of natural gas. And finally, Rare Earth Minerals said first results from drilling at the El Sauz Fleur lithium concessions in Mexico have shown continuity with the adjoining La Ventana concession. Rare Earth is exploring El Sauz jointly with Bacanora Minerals, with 2 holes drilled so far. The company said the results of the first 2 holes successfully demonstrate the clay units of the La Ventana lithium deposit run into the Fleur concession. And that's it for today's main stories today.